did they just stop because of the shot clock? Let's wait and see. A timeout has been called by Cal State San Bernardino. Jarrett Gray on the drive. There are 5.3 seconds remaining. And now they're waiting to see whether or not timeout was called. All right, Jerry Menesey gets told by Kirk Rowe. Man-to-man, full court. Brown is at the far end, the long heave end. Everybody else in the backcourt. And now the Cavs slack a little bit with it. Efferson against Edward. Efferson for the win. Off the rim, Michaels the rebound. And the Cavaliers lead in the game for a total of 5 seconds. Jeff Oliver gracious, congratulating the Cavalier players and coaches. Well, it was overtime last night. It was a winner with 5 seconds remaining from Jarrett Gray. '65-'64, Concordia over Cal State San Bernardino as Jarrett Gray joins us courtside here. Hit the game winner with 5.3 seconds remaining. Nothing like leading in a game for just 5 seconds.
It's crazy. That was a crazy game. The crowd really got into it at the end, which is a huge help. And, I mean, everyone stepped up big and played their part and we're able to come out with a victory today.
Here, come slide this way a little bit so we can get you on camera and maybe get people out of the way there a bit. I want to know about the mentality that it takes, the confidence that it takes to be the guy in a go-to situation. I mean, it's nothing new for you, but when you know it's on the line, I want to hear a little bit about what goes through your mind and through your heart at a moment like that.
At a moment like that, I'm just trying really not to think about anything, clear my mind, and just kind of do what comes naturally and do what instinct is. But, I mean, I can't do any of that without my teammates who played great today and were drawing everyone out and giving me lanes to be able to attack the basket and score. So
it was difficult getting points early on. Their help side, you know, throughout their pack line was really solid. What adjustments did you guys make as a team to get better looks, to get better production in the second half?
Coming out in the second half, we decided just kind of move the ball more and make them guard for longer in the shot clock instead of coming down and taking quick shots. They're a great defensive team, and they really played well today, but we were able to the second half really move the ball more and get it inside and create open space and space it out for everyone to be able to drive.
At the same time, you guys also played better team defense during the second half. Their percentage dropped precipitously in the second half of play.
Same thing coming out of halftime. We just talked. We were happy with how we played in the first half, but we just weren't getting stuff to fall. And we knew second half, the first 4 minutes were going to be crucial on defense, especially getting stops. They're a team that likes to push it and get out and transition. So, I mean, the key was just to kind of keep them out of the lanes and make them become contested shooters.
And this team with a lot of new players, a lot of new faces, really showed some heart after you came to tie it with a little less than 8 minutes to go. Fell back behind again, a point where a lot of teams might have said, well, that was our effort for the night, but you guys were able to sustain a rally again all the way to the wire.
Yeah, this team, we play with a lot of heart. Everybody from first guy to last plays their hardest day in and day out at practice, and that's really translating over in these last couple games. I mean, we got fighting this, and we're never going to give up until the buzzer sounds. So,
what does it say about this group, again, still getting used to one another a little bit on the floor, to come up with two big wins like that on the opening weekend of play?
It's huge. I mean, we're like you said, we're still trying to get used to each other. There's a couple games into the season, so it's huge to come away with two big wins against great teams on an opening weekend. Start the season 2-0.
Off to Idaho now for two more. San Francisco State and the Academy of Art. And in talking with coaches over the years, sometimes that first road trip gives a great chance for everybody to get a little bit more bonding in, to get used to one another when it's your own isolated group, us against the world on the road.
Yeah, we've been fortunate enough already to play a couple of exhibition games on the road, so we kind of have that kind of going already, and we know what to expect. Going into Nampa next week to Northwest Nazarene, it'll be a tough one, but we're looking forward to it.
I know you've got some folks you like to visit with and celebrate this one a little bit. Great clutch performance, and leading score on the night unofficially was 16. Thanks for the time, and we'll look forward to seeing you back here in a couple of weeks.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Thank you.